part of self-care is being strong enough to have amazing women in your life.
And you know what? The fact that you said strong enough is real.
Hi, I'm Sanaa Lathan, and I'm here on the set of What Had Happened Was with my great friend, Regina Hall. We are here to talk about self-love and Nappily Ever After.
Mm-hmm. How do you define self-love? Mm.
The first thing that self-love is talking to yourself in a loving way. Mm. You would never talk to your sister or your mother in a derogatory way, but we tear ourselves apart all day, every day. Even if you have the thought, changing the thought in the moment.
I always believe self-love, you can't help but love other people. Self-love reverberates.
It's so true.
Out to everyone. And if you begin with that, then how you treat other people and...
Yes.
And how you are affected. And then...
Yeah, so if you're finding yourself being a bitch to other people and mean to other people and doing nasty things to other people, you have to look at how you feel about yourself. How do you define self-love?
Well, what's my phrase?
She'll be like, Sanaa, just don't sweat it. We're all going to be dust one day. And I was like, we're all going to be dust? And it's true.
And so we might as well love on ourselves. For both of us being... not married, and the kind of man that we would be with, we would have to have the self-love, which is what I loved about the movie, that it's not about her ending up with a guy or finding the perfect guy. It's creating that love within herself.
When you've gone through, like, a heartbreak or a life crisis, I've seen you really come back and come out stronger.
I have a tendency, you know this, to retreat.
She needs to kind of go inward into her own cocoon.
Yeah.
When she's going through stuff, and I'm the opposite. I just am like, Regina, can you come over, please?
Yeah, and it's like, it's different, but it's great because no matter what, even when I do that, then I have, you know, like my best friend there in stillness to support me. Also, part of self-care is being strong enough to have amazing women in your life.
And you know what? The fact that you said strong enough is real.
You gotta have friends in your life who will
tell you the truth, too. And that's big for this business that we're in.
Very.
You can get to a certain place and, you know, you have people around you who won't check you.
Now, we have each other and, you know, other good friends. Who does Violet have?
Violet has two great friends. We thought that that was really important to have her girlfriends kind of help her along this journey and witness her. And it's light and it's funny at times, but that relationship with other women was important to us.
Wow.
Wow. Oh, wow. Just wow.
Yeah.
I think it's hot. I mean, I don't really know if it's you. You know, maybe you just want to keep it simple.
Yeah, just be yourself.
Yeah. And what would that be? The anal compulsive Miss Perfect cut or the not fun, never spontaneous weave?
I mean, personally, I like the weave. It was cute.
I love that she has a sisterhood in the film holding her while she goes through her inner and outer transformation, I guess.
Yeah, one of the things that appealed to me with the ending of the movie is it's not the traditional romantic comedy and the girl or the guy gets the girl or the guy gets the guy. She kind of chooses herself.
She falls in love with Violet.
She falls in love with herself. That's just an ongoing theme right now, I think. You know, this whole idea of marriage, which, yes, if I meet the right person one day, I would love to be married. But if I don't, I'm good. I am responsible for the joy and the love in my life.
That's what I so love about this movie, about Nappily Ever After, about what you gave to that character, about what we get to experience watching it. As a woman who's been in relationships and gone through breakups, like to see that on screen and to see Violet fall in love with herself and be stripped the most beautiful, bare part of herself and her soul. And that's what I love, too, about the journey of the movie and the journey of the character and the journey of the hair, all of it. It's reassessing what is the perfect life.
Yeah, something happens when you get to be a certain age and people look at you like something's wrong with you if you don't or you're not married. And, and that's part of what I'm trying to break with this kind of new fairy tale. Yes, marriage is beautiful, but marriage for the sake of marriage can be a nightmare.
Yeah.
I always say we're like snowflakes. No, nobody is the same. No life should be the same. Nobody should be taught that they're less than because they haven't conformed.
And so let's have a toast to self-love, self-care, to Violet and her journey. And what is the name of this drink?
Self-care sunrise.
I love that.
It's a violent.
Thank you so much for doing this, Regina.
Oh, I had so much fun.